Alrighty then, enough of that, enough of Apocalypse Now and Ride of the Valkyries. We're here with WePlay Season 3, the draft has begun. Vega Squadron take on HellRaisers, and HellRaisers, well, they honestly have to raise hell against Vega, because Vega sitting 7-2 up at the top of the board, while HR are 1-4, as we get ourselves into picks and Radiant bans, team. And I can welcome in my co-caster, Ryu. What's going on, man?
Hello? HellRaisers, what?
Hi!
Erica?
I can hear you.
Okay, okay.
There was just like that. There was like a long ass pause, like, hey Ryu, what's going on? And then. Silence.
No, I this is what I do. I listen, and I'm looking at stuff, and then eventually I unpause. Mm-hmm. Or I mute myself when you're done and you say my name, and then I still wait like an extra second or two to gather everything that I want to say right before.
Radiant.
So there is a little bit, you know, 4 or 5 second window there.
Sends me into a panic. Like, oh god, can you hear me? Is it working?
Yeah,
did I forget to call him? Did I forget to set things up? But
yeah, sometimes there is wonky stuff. I know the feeling. We have a lot of issues at times with microphones and. Whatnot.
It's all fine, I'm sure. Right, best of one between these two teams. The only best of one for CIS today. We've got one game, and then there's a game later on at 9:15 p.m. Which I think Drag and Drop is covering. But this draft, Zeus, Nature's Prophet. Not a massive surprise. CIS teams have been loving this combo and just dominating with it, honestly. Jumping around the map. Safe lane Prophet, off lane Prophet, mid Zeus. Just run at people. Make up the numbers with the TPs in. While HellRaisers, Oracle Puck is an opener I have never seen.
Yeah, I'm really confused they wouldn't start off with, say, like, Earth Spirit and Puck. Because Zeus is really weak in the laning phase, and it is so easy just to gank him with a Bounty Hunter, or even Bounty Hunter, Spirit Breaker, and Earth Spirit come to mind. I mean, you just get an Orb Venom on any of these heroes, and you just constantly chase them, and normally you see a couple with like Invoker, with Cold Snap and Sunstrike, or anything basically can kill the Zeus. That's where you really want to punish him, because like you said, once the globals start coming online,
Radiant
that's when
back.
Vega's squadron's lineup can come online and they can get back into the game by getting these pickoffs around the map. So Oracle, I guess you could say, will help a lot against the burst damage. Obviously the Fate's Edict will help a lot against the magic immunity.
10 seconds remaining.
We'll have to see how it works in the team fights and what they're trying to couple with the Oracle right now, because you normally pick that, right? When you have a DP, maybe they're looking to get the Sven still, and just like, he's going
to
be a god, he's going to be on the front lines, and we're going to keep him alive while he just mows down everything.
Okie dokie. Well, the ban's out. Hang on a second. Why am I too loud? Interesting. I'll turn myself down a touch. I am too loud. I don't know why. There's been gremlins in here touching all the buttons. Oh my god, is that like your Mary Poppins accent or something? That is the worst.
I am like an old grandma.
Yeehaw! I'm from Texas. I love guns. That's my impression of you, Ryu. I hope that's okay.
Shut up, you fat cow.
You hippo. You bloody hippo. Right, Enchantress, Vengeful Spirit, AA, all taken out. I mean, the AA ban, is that indicative of anything, or is that just a global presence? So Vega Squadron so far, okay, yep, looks like it's Spectre. Oh my goodness, this used to be just like a pub stomping strat, you know? 3K, 4K, 5K scrubs, group up as 5, go into a pub game, let's go global. Let's pick Zeus, Nature's Prophet, Spectre, AA, Invoker, and let's just kill everyone. Just destroy everyone. HellRaisers don't want any of it, but Vega, they still get their hands on the Spectre. Ryu, how do you deal with global power?
They got the one
Vega
hero that wanted him to get the Earth Spirit. We can take it to the Zeus now early
Witch
game.
Doctor.
You can shut him down in the levels a bit. And just get your Puck to a fast Blink Dagger so he can control the tempo of the game where you're constantly going in onto Vega Squadron. You just have to have a lot of sustain too. Obviously, we talked about the heals that can come in from Oracle. Now, what's really nice would be a Chin, but it's banned out. Another hero that's pretty good is kind of a Darkseer in the sense where if they have Darkseer who can get like a mech
remaining.
And a pipe, then a lot of this damage is mitigated coming in from Vega. So I look for heroes like that that can get online early. And then normally when there's a Spectre, you can get away with it. And then you also have the combo Darkseer plus Puck here. So I think it's a perfect pick here. Maybe they're thinking of a Tide, though. Like, what do you think they want?
Like, with the Oracle Puck opener, I have no idea what they want. I'm looking at this Earth Spirit, and I agree with you. You know, with a Puck, the Zeus is going to have some troubles. But having a Witch Doctor, Nature's Prophet, able to, like, TP in and react to what's going on... I kind of feel Hellraisers have to win their lanes and be active the first 10 minutes or so before this level 6 just hate train comes out of Vega. Being active around the map and being mobile, being able to react to what's going on against, you know, TPing Nature's Prophet, Spectre with the Haunt... And the Witch Doctor, he isn't bad at TPing in and throwing a cask out. And the final hero for Vega, and it's probably going to be that final support hero. Never quite sure what they're going to go for, but HR, you know, Juggernaut is out there. It's like the solid, stable carry. But against this Vega lineup that can split push, can team fight early, can definitely group up and take towers, I think they need some kind of early fighting power, but also some displacement to just catch someone and drag them away. So Batrider is going to be a good pickup, but Gyro, I think, is going to be the final hero for them. Just have Dreamcoil cooldown, make sure that you can catch Vega off guard, a couple of good smokes, and Hellraisers could find themselves in a pretty good position after laning stage.
It's not too bad. Definitely want to have some AoE insurance. Radiant team Morphling wasn't too bad either in this situation. Obviously, E-Blade will wreck face all these heroes in there. They have no catch to really stop the Morphling from farming. So Vega, you know, we're talking about their lineup. They can definitely get on people pretty easily here and quickly. So they would like to have another stun to really couple up with these. Trying to think what's going to be good. Like, Spirit Breaker came to mind.
Vega squadrons turn to pick.
What else is there? Tusk isn't that bad when you're trying to set up. It can also save a lot for Vega. It can help roaming. Might want to have it just in case the Zeus gets dive mid, and then you can come in, maybe get a potential turnaround kill.
How about something like a Sand King? Just having like that Sand King go boots first, roam around a bit, control the offlane, and then be able to like dip back into the jungle to get his Blink Dagger. And then you've got, because right now Vega don't really have any great counter initiation tools, just having someone that can kind of sit back, wait for that jump in, a Sand King, an Earthshake or something like that to stop the bat, because they don't have anything to really limit the Batrider's movement in teamfights. No Sprout.
They don't have anything to really initiate in besides like... you know, burst damage coming in from the Zeus and Nature's Prophet and them setting up. Sand King can definitely help when you're trying to turn around or initiate in team fights.
Sand King, Earthshaker. What else could we look for? I kind of just want someone tanky that can just run into the middle of a fight. You mentioned Tusk. Wouldn't be too bad. I don't know, there aren't that many options unless you want to look for something like an Enigma that just goes straight into the jungle.
Yeah, I was thinking
jungle.
Enigma too at the last second there.
But then you're against
to have some stain and push.
You're against Boulder Smash, Dream Coil, and Flame Break. But Disruptor, that's a pretty decent counter initiator. Can initiate as well if you want to. Throw the Static Storm down. And also good against Batrider. That's what Vega's been looking for. Hellraisers, what is your plan? Is it the Gyro? Is it going to be something like a Wraith King? Because it is Illidan on this carry. So that Morphling ban, you know, very good. He's been playing a spectacular Morphling recently. But Illidan has a lot more tricks up his sleeve. The one hero that I'm kind of looking at and wondering, you know, how the hell it got through pick and ban phase was OD. But safe lane OD hasn't been something people have been really toying around with too much.
Anti-mage.
It's the Illidan AM. Okay.
This hero is really good in this situation because there's the Zeus to really pop. Nature's Prophet's going to be split pushing a lot. You can just go in with Batrider, Puck, Blink Daggers, and then Anti-Mage just free farming. And then in the later stage of the game, normally Anti-Mage will be like 5,000 above the Spectre, just because we've seen Spectres nowadays go for the Manta into Diffusals and whatnot. So they're not going to be having a Radiance, not as farming as fast as they used to. So I think Anti-Mage will come out on top in the farming speed, and then, yeah, Anti-Mage definitely need a BKB this game, and then that's when he's going to go ham onto the Spectre, onto all of these heroes. So if he can farm up the up to the Manta, Battle Fury, remaining. And then BKB, and they're not too far behind, I think HellRaisers can definitely take it to remaining. Vega pretty easily.
Alrighty then. Let's have a look at what they're going to be up to as we get ourselves into the game. Of course, one sec is needed. Got to go over the game plan. Got to figure out how they defeat the global strat. So, Shyama the Slayer on the Disruptor, Solo Witch Doctor, Mag, the Nature's Prophet, Pasha, and no one on the Spectre and the Zeus, and over on the Radiant, Illidan's Anti-Mage. I mean, he's set some records in the past. Let's see if he can break some today. Shashlo is playing the Batrider, Godam, and Yolo Warrior. We're on the Oracle and Earth Spirit. Probably two of the more interesting supports out there nowadays, and Alpha playing his pretty good puck recently. He's had some damn nice performances on that hero. He's also going to have the help of the Earth Spirit just roaming around towards mid. Solo TP's out towards the mid lane. Gets an early Observer Ward down. And yet to see exactly what Mag plans to do on his bot. You know, does he double stack up the creep wave to drag it back to his tower? How much trouble does the Nature's Prophet get in up against Oracle plus AM?
You're just going to have to be very quick on your TP's away. Once he starts channeling his fortunes in, because once we see the Oracle's level 3, they're going to get off two Purifying Flames, it feels like, before you get the TP away, and then you're just bursted down because of the heavy nukes. So have to be on your toes there, and just knowing when to TP away. Also need to be very careful you don't get mana burned too much, else your TP is going to be canceled there.
Apparently now I'm too quiet in Dota TV.
It's too quiet, too loud. Late for Durka. There's always next game. Oh wait.
Oh wait, there is
only a best of one.
Too loud, too quiet, too everything. Let's
the
turn,
battle begins.
Let's turn that down and turn that up and see Surprise. How we are. Oh goodness. And then the camera goes crazy and it goes scrolling away. Yeah, like Zoidberg. Why not Zoidberg? So, Bounty Rune apiece. Puck and Zeus get their hands on those little bad boys. And the lanes. Oh, look at these treants. Oh, little treants. They're so cute. Oh, no, they're not. They're super ugly. Is he going to drag these coops back? I'm getting held out by Fortune's End and stuff. But it looks like Mag's got good control. And just wander them around. Hilton, he's got second thoughts about this. He wants to try and get this creep wave to meet. And doesn't look like they'll be able to. Oh, God. I'm too busy watching treants while middle lane someone dies. Solo's gone. The Witch Doctor's dead. T-tours begin. Sorry for that.
I should be keeping my eyes on the Earth Spirit because I know what the hero can do. Since I'm an Earth Spirit picker nowadays.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, I was really intrigued by the trees dying.
Yeah, I know. It's just like, watch the trees. Watch the trees. And then there's a dual lane at mid as Apple gets his name up on the board. Oh my goodness, that's a good start. We've got one best of one and I fucked it up already.
Good. Normally I'm on my toes too, but I was tunnel visioning. That's how you give first bloods. Paying attention to that minimap.
I'll just blame you. It's all fine. So, trial up at top. Disruptor Spectre plus the Witch Doctor now. Solo. He's given up on mid lane. And no one's going to be left to his own devices. He does have his bottle, though. Already ferrying it to himself and back again. But Alpha with a double fairy fire. This damage output. 64 base damage. There's very little no one can do to really stop the puck from farming. Or trade hits with him. Oh, Korea getting very close there. We might see Mag TP in to try and snipe it out, actually. Radiant, you've got to keep tabs on this Nature's Prophet. Because he's the one to go and TP to look for these Korea kills. But he doesn't have a scroll. He's not going to be able to TP in, then TP out. Won't give it a go. Shardslow, what's he up to? Stacking camps for himself. He's got this large camp actually being stacked up pretty juicy. Oh no. Time to watch chat. Run, little trees, run. And then the T-tour spam begins. Oh, the 2-minute delay is lovely. Right, Illidan's Anti-Mage, 7-4. He's actually been shot out a fair amount down on this bottom lane. They've moved the Earth Spirit in to really try and consolidate and secure this, but Mag, he can just move back to this jungle camp.
Yeah, mid lane is going just a little bit here for Afo Ninja. It's still Zeus should be able to farm really effectively. He's bottle crowing now too, and with level 2 arc lightning, it's impossible to miss last hits. So still pretty good. And yeah, looking at the offlane, Chastelo, he doesn't have his boots yet. He's stacking with an image too, but Soma's here. He just blocked the creep. This is pretty good for him now, and they're going to be shutting down the Batrider as much as they can.
Yeah, this does mean that Solo can get all his stacks and pulls off pretty nicely. And Pasha, leading up on these last hits, the Spectre, he's going to be a force to be reckoned with. Oh, Batrider, he's being found here. He's got Sticky Napalm and Firefly with the Thunderstrike down. Sioma's taking a ton of damage. And Shashlo might be able to chase this through, but Pasha comes in to bully him out a little bit more. And with a TP in from Mag, they're going to try and right-click him with a glimpse back into danger. He's going to run to the right, but he's got nowhere to turn. Fairy Fire will keep him alive a little bit longer. But Vega still finds the kill up on this top lane. And good TP in from Mag, again, making up these numbers. And Sioma's a little bait there, you know? It's a lonely disruptor, thinking you're going to be able to get that kill or just do enough damage to force him away and stop annoying you on this lane.
Yeah, he would have enough for his boots if he sold his clarity and went to the side shop, and that would have saved his life. And he could have potentially got the kill as well, so just kind of underestimating how much they could really do there. Did he use his mango? No, he still hasn't even used his mango in Soma, so he's going to have that ready whenever he wants to do these plays, because obviously you have Thunderstrike that costs 130, Sent Glimpses 100, and the Kinetic Field 70, so he's not playing with a lot of mana right now. And having this Mango early on could lead to another kill. Shashlo, it will have his boots now, level 3, so dying there, not the end of the world.
They're aiming for mid again. Alpha's doing a great job, actually. Dodging out these Arc Lightnings with his Phase Shift, trying to get away from that Static Field as well. But Ivan, YOLO Warrior, the Earth Spirit, he's waiting around mid, leeching level 3. And he's actually just going to go back and stack a camp, not moving in to be the aggressor onto No One Zeus. Being a little more passive on this Earth Spirit.
Dire's bottom tower is
definitely a hero that you can make things happen early on, but laning stage early on for HellRaisers here, it's going decently enough. You know, they're getting a lot out of their lanes, anti-mage is farming pretty well, not being forced out or shut down, and Solo, he's actually been given the reins of the offlane, trying to get some experience and gather what he can from this bot.
Yeah, they're playing way too passive. Once the attack. Globals that we've talked about come online from Zeus and Sirion, this is getting very scary. Oh. Got Yellow Warrior here.
He can roll away. The cast comes through. Oh, maybe he can't. They're going to catch him. Mag with a good placement of his body. Blocks off Ivan. But the damage isn't there. He salves himself up until the Thunder God's Wrath comes through. No one secures a kill at long last.
Yep. So a lot of rotations coming over, but I'm trying to figure out who that favors in the long run, because that was only a level 3 Earth Spirit and you wasted Zeus ulti. Now they Radiant's can get very active around attack. The map from HellRaisers. Maybe they can take something, but because of their lineup, even if they get kills on the side of HellRaisers, they can't take any towers. It's just kind of like, we're going to make as much space as we can with the Anti-Mage here, let them farm up and try to get kills elsewhere. But
yeah, it kind of feels like they're going to be relying quite heavily on the split push from Anti-Mage. And then they fight as 4 or something with the rest of their team around tier 1, tier 2 towers. I swear Pasha didn't look like this a second ago.
Dire's bottom tower Pasha is looks under attack.
Am I crazy? Maybe I am. Pasha looks different on the Spectre. Whatever.
Maybe it's because it's nighttime. Who knows?
Maybe it is, actually.
You know, I don't even know about the cosmetic stuff because I just accept the items in my inventory. I don't question them. Like, oh, I got this. That's pretty nice. Yeah, speaking of items, real quick, screw the new whatever the Winter Zeus Pass. It's like just as bad as last season. I get no good drops or rares or any crap.
Oh, come on, dude. Like the compendium.
And I'm good.
This winter Battle Pass is so much better than all the compendiums.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing, but at the same time, the luck is still horse crap.
Oh, so you haven't won any Arcanas?
No, I have. Oh. I haven't got diddly, and I'm level like 20 or something.
That's a shame.
Leveling up is not leveling up my luck.
One of the Chinese casters in this game actually is like level 80 or something already. It's crazy. How do you do this? Just throw money at the screen and buy all the chests.
I'm just gonna play normal matches, honestly. Like normal matches, and that's where you just get the free easy wins.
Do all the quests.
Just like, oh, I'll just be able to do every single quest. and get 250 every time you bet, you win.
Well, for now, Pasha, he's pretending to be Batman. Full man shield, earn phase boots. So they're going to the old drums, Yasha, see where he heads from there. We're going to Matterstar, Diffusal Blade, Radiance. Like, what do you think? Is Radiance good here? Or do you just want to go for, like, the kind of earlier battle? Oh, they're going in on bottom lane. But here's the horn in from Pasha. Yola Warrior, he's used his roll forward already. And Thundercut's Wrath expended again for a kill on him. But they've seen Goddamn. A TP forward from Mag will secure this kill as well with a Sprout. And the right click's coming through. Goddamn doesn't really stand a goddamn chance with a glimpse back as well. He'll secure that kill, but Illidan wants the fight. He's got his ulti. The Mana Boy is ready, but he's blinked in aggressively. The damage output from Vega here is just too big. And Illidan, too big for his own boots. There's five heroes from Vega. Converge onto this bottom lane and push on in.
Yeah, HellRaisers did not play aggressive enough early on with their heroes. And it's 8 minutes in the game, and we still haven't seen a Puck Dream Coil. This is... I'm just saying they're not really executing their lineup to perfection or even half of it right now, because they're not getting aggressive anywhere, and it's Vega putting in all the pressure everywhere now, and their ultis are down, so HellRaisers have to make something happen now. You have Batrider online, Puck still doesn't have his blink, but still, you need to go somewhere and get something done now.
And this is where the domino effect starts. This is where Vega start jumping from lane to lane. Why HellRaisers have smoked up, looking for this aggressive play with all their ultis available. Well, I say all of the ultis that, you know, they've leveled up, because Earth Spirit and Oracle are yet to hit level 6. They might be able to find Pasha here. He doesn't have mana for a dagger, and with a Dream Coil and damage output, HellRaisers should be able to secure this kill pretty easily for Illidan to steal it out as well. That Mana Void coming through solo, just being right click down, plinked away at. Another orb forward. He's got his stick charges up, and he dodges the orb, so there's no more push forward here. The advance is over for HellRaisers. He got that Spectre. That's a pretty big kill.
Yeah, it's a big kill, but I don't know if it's enough. Now they're all their ultis are online, and then HellRaisers, did they get a Blink Dagger on any of their cores yet? No, not just yet. So they still need a little bit more space. But now Vega can get really aggressive anywhere on the map, and they have to be very careful from HellRaisers. Illidan,
is he in trouble? Oh, they're just waiting for that static storm to be placed. Illidan, he still can't blink. The Sprout pushes him away, but they have the glimpse anyway. Again with that ultimate combo out from Vega. So much damage. And they've still got mags to throw if they really want it. So they're gonna hunt down no one up at top. Towards the rune spot. He picked up a DD, but he's just getting jumped on by Apo here with the silence forward. The Dream Coil available in a second. It might just throw this out, but a TP in from Solo will come in, heal him up. No mana for Kaska, no one's still dying. He's taken out, and Solo. Oh man. He still has no mana.
Nice.
HR. And find a couple of kills, but that's down to Vega. I mean, you look at the Witch Doctor, you think, right, TP's in, he Voodoo Restoration's up, but with no mana for Kask, no way of saving that, no one Zeus.
Yeah, that's kind of baited him. He could have potentially, well, I don't know if he had the teleport scroll, I wasn't able to really see. Maybe the Zeus could have TP'd away and lived, but like you said, hey, that's an easy turnaround play because we're going to have Kask, we're going to have the heals up, and my Witch Doctor has no mana. Just kidding, guys. I'm just kidding. I'm just here to die with you. With you, friend.
Okay,
but
so
there you go. Pasha, you have your answer. He's going to go for the drums first. And sometimes I like seeing people skip drums and go for Manta. Because in this situation, you have two silences that you really want to dodge out. One Puck is going to have a blink. And then the two is going to be the Earth Spirit. And obviously, it helps tremendously bursting out your DPS with the Desolate here when you have it. So I would have really loved to see him skip the drums, though. But it helps so much when you're moving in team fights, and I can understand why he wants to go for it.
Yeah, with Mag going the mech build, actually. It's been a while since I've seen Utility Nature's Prophet. Mag is going mech. You're not going to have that Nature's Prophet phase boots drums. He's not going to go for the Midas. So just tanking up on the Spectre is definitely going to be very important for you. But the double blink threat is available now for HR. Bat and Puck both have their jumps available, and they're all grouped up towards the top lane. As Ivan smoked up, Alpha Ninja is actually invis with that rune he picked up. Not being able to find anyone, though, as they're all down at bottom lane. Pash is hiding away in the trees. Not farming, just, you know, sitting around, waiting for this storm to pass. I'll get himself out of there, back to safety. But no one looks like they want to try and fight this. They've got their global power. They have all their ultis available. Just need Solo to TP up there with the help of Sioma as well. And they're buying their TPs up. They're going to jump in straight away. And there we go. Blink Lasso onto no one. They've got Illidan right clicking him down, but the Thunderbolt Wrath is already used. There's the Mana Void. Clears him up with a Batrider. But Illidan glimpsed back into danger. And Pasha should be able to clear this up with his right click attacks. And all the blinks available again with a Cask and Death Ward. Solo with a timing. Three dead, and Vega only lose one. This is the power of Vega Squadron. You want to push into their towers? No siree. We're going to go straight back into you.
Yep. Once again, it's Soma being a standout player, you know, just dropping the static storm on people's heads when they can't blink out, they can't illusion out or anything. Shutting down the puck there was nice. Both teams got a really good initiate, but at the end of the day, the glimpse back won them that team fight. And this is just more pressure coming in from Vega. It's what their lineup's meant to do. Without the Nature's Prophet, this lineup would be pretty garbage, right? It would have just a Zeus and a Furion, but you don't have as much power in the tower. It's just so funny watching that.
That buff to their base damage, huh? The 32 base damage. Headbutting towers down so the puck can't deny it. They're still grouped up behind this Spectre, though. Maybe expecting to jump on in. HellRaisers. Still yet to get level 6 on this Earth Spirit. Level 7.5 though on the Oracle, so at least they now have the False Promise to play with. But Earth Spirits, we've seen them kind of falter or rise to fame like Bounty Hunters, right? Initial stages of the game are so reliant on your rotations and your movements and your ganks and just landing your spells. And also the opponents being a little too aggressive. But the fact that no one was playing Zeus and being so passive in lane, there was, you know, limited opportunities to catch him out. And honestly, Ivan, he spent a lot of the time kind of just stacking, farming jungle, trying to get as much gold and experience as he could. It's a difficult old game for him, but one team fight is all they need. And with a grab onto no one, glimpse back is good, but they jump forward still with Alpha there. Stack Storm is down. They have the Death Ward available as well. It's going to be a one-for-one trade-off. But maybe they'll look for more. Vega, they're on the hunt, trying to catch Shachlow. And Pasha, he's specked it up onto the cliff. He's chasing the Batrider. He's got one more click to finish him off. But with a roll away, Ivan and Goddam, they will retreat. TP from Mag. Guess is wrong.
They've got vision almost for Glimpse.
And they've got the haunt now. Yeah. They definitely do. There's the kickback, the boulder smash. But they've got the glimpse onto Ivan. He TPs himself away. But there's Cask and stuns galore.
They're even chasing down Goddam here. All right. Pasha, yep. Easy
to kill. Oh,
maybe not.
Got him. He's dead. Four gone. And Illidan. He is the last man remaining, just farming on his bottom lane, desperately scrambling to get into his battle fury.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. I mean, we haven't even really seen the sustain coming in, just because it's been like a pick off. But Solo's leveling up his voodoo restoration. Obviously, we talked about it. Mag has his mech. And then the scariest part is, they're the team that has the heavy burst damage coming out of them. They have the Zeus, the Furion, and the Spectre. Whereas HellRaisers, yeah, they do have some burst damage with the puck in, and then we still haven't had the Earth Spirit level 6. Finally, now we got Magnetize online. But they're just getting picked apart when HellRaisers are supposed to be doing that job.
Well, Alpha, your puck. It's been pretty good recently, but you've got a lot of catching up to do. Mag has the mech. And we haven't even seen this utilized yet, so like you're saying, the sustained pushes, that sustained team fight, that Vega, they kick it off with all this burst damage you're talking about, but they've got the items to follow through as well. You know, Witch Doctor's going to have a medallion soon, so Roche taking is going to be easier. I'm just wondering what no one's building on the Zeus, you know, after Aetherlands. There are just so many branches you can go out to. The Veil is going to be his option here. You know, there's Yule Scepter, Force Staff, Blink Dagger. You can go Bloodstone if you want to. But he's going to go Veil, and what do you think he goes after that? Mobility? Octarine?
I like Yule's still this game for... Well, Yule's this game for Puck, and Yule's this game for Zeus. I think it just allows your team to just help you and set up in a lot of situations. Being up in the air for those, you know, 2 seconds, it really helps you come back down and then reposition. It'll help a lot for the Static Storm for Afo Ninja. Hopefully can get out of the kinetic field by then. in some situations, maybe wait out that duration and then obviously help. And then for the Zeus, obviously it'll help out a lot. Just for even if the anti-mage blinks in on you. I don't know. That's what I'm kind of worried about too, right? You kind of need a four staff. If the anti-mage blinks in you and then you don't have a way to really get out, then if he just yules up in the air, he surrounds you and then two, three more right clicks and then he mana voids you and you're dead, so.
Well, Illidan has his item. He's got the Battle Fury. Looking at the net worth, Puck and Zeus, pretty bang on even. But then you've got this Nature's Prophet up at the top, even without a Midas. Mag has been farming spectacularly. He's 305. And I guess with no death, he's kept every single penny he's earned. And into Rosh they go, Medallion Mech, Voodoo Restoration, and more damage than HellRaisers could ever dream of. As they move into this pit, and they're going to secure the Aegis. Yasha's up for Pasha. Yasha. Sioma the Slayer, just sitting around with Arcane's Cloak. But Shardslow looks like he wants to try and scout. No. Firefly's over. He's not going to scout this out. There's no way. I think he sees Sioma down during the daytime. He's going to find out with the Flame Break in. Ooh. I was close to stealing it, but not close enough, buddy.
I think if he had blinked in, he would have stole it, but it was Firefly and cooldown, obviously, so he couldn't go in. That could have been a huge play coming in from HellRaisers, but opting out the safe route. And you know, he has his four staff now. He's going to need a BKB if he really wants to survive in the team fight. Obviously, a lot of these glimpses are hurting his Flaming Lasso. Well, there we go.
Are you jumping in on bot lane? Yeah, they are. Batrider's caught. Well, that's a couple of ulties used, though. There are three
they're
big global
ones.
Oh, they're all, oh my god, you're right. They're all pretty much dead. Like four of them running back to the base. Guys! Oh, I love the smell of napalm in the morning. Look at them. Just being devastated by this powerful global strat, and they smoke up. I guess they know the ulties are down, right? So what better time to fight than now? Let's go. Scorched Earth policy. No one left behind. Just run straight on in. Batrider is alive in 14 seconds. But this has to pay off for HellRaisers. If they lose this team fight, the game could very well just be straight up over. And Vega, they're going to get wrapped around on. Sioma still has the Static Storm. Solo still has the Death Ward. They're going to straight in onto the support, though. Disruptor being dropped low, but Solo, he's got the ulti down to the Storm onto Yolo Warrior. They're going to kill off the Zeus at the very least. But look at Illidan. He's dropping low as well. Vega, they're just healing through it all, and Avenger's going to get chased back. The Puck has nowhere to retreat to apart from the enemy base. Blink away, my friend. Try and escape. But it's just being ticked over and taken out. Three are dead from HellRaisers, and that was their aggression move. That was their Hail Mary play. Without the Batrider, it just didn't work out and didn't pay off.
Yeah, you have to have Soma and Solo really shut down, because once he gets the cast off, and as long as he has the heal on, then the mech coming in for Mag, there's no way to kill these guys. Like, it has to come out to be a huge mana void coming in from the anti-mage on, like, two, three heroes. And it didn't happen during that team fight. Tower has fallen. And now Pasha has his Manta style. He still has the Aegis. Oh. They did everything right, though, that team fight for HellRaisers. They went on the Disruptor. You have to burst him or silence him first, but they weren't able to burst him down. In that 4v5 situation.
They want to kill Pasha now. Batrider's got his Firefly up, but it's about to expire. With Aegis on the Spectre, it's not really the best target you can go for.
That's a suicide mission.
It really is. And poor Ivan on this Earth Spirit. 1100 gold, he can afford his Arcane Boots now. It's 21 minutes in though, and he's only level 8. And it's just systematic destruction here from Vega. Tower after tower, team fight after team fight. 7-17 is the score on the doors at 21.5 minutes, and with the Aegis still lasting another two. You just wonder, can Vega just push high ground here with all the royalties available?
Oh, seems like it. No really point in backing off. They have full sustained mana, and they can just go high ground here. They won last team fight. The only thing that's really going to hurt them is Shashlo, but they have to get the Puck silence on Soma first, as he's trying to go back with the lasso.
It's going to be a difficult initiation, but they found Mag at the back. They're going to try and nuke him down, but he just heals himself up, and there we go, the big global power. HellRaisers, this is problematic. Buyback from Ivan, but I think this might just be over. Vega, they're the ones up on the high ground still sustaining through all of that damage, and HellRaisers have nothing left. They've got Mana Void as their only real big spell available to them. And Illidan having Battle Fury Yasha definitely doesn't help. No mana style, no real way to jump into this team fight. The glyph is out, but buddies, Ivan, try your hardest, but Pasha has Aegis still. Mjolnir's fully done up on this Nature's Prophet. Shasta's just gonna get taken out. He walks himself into death, but the Pulse Force will keep him alive a little bit longer as Pasha swipes down Illidan in the middle of five. The Vega Squadron gonna take the first racks of the game at 22 minutes of the roll in, looking for the kill on Solo, but Ivan can't find it. The Glimmer Cape is there and Solo gets himself away. Goddamn over on the side, gonna get zapped down by the lightning stick of Mag. In the sprout you go and down you are. Dig your own grave. At least they'll get one. They found the kill on Solo, and at this point, Puck is dead. Returns to the land of the living, straight back down, 6 feet under. GG's called.
Well, you call him Ivan, YOLO Warrior, I call him you're welcome for the free win. I don't know. You just have to make those aggressive plays early on. There is plenty of opportunities for mid lane to just go in on the Zeus constantly and rotate in. It's the play you have to keep making constantly because you're not going to get kills on the Nature's Prophet in the bottom lane. And you're not going to go obviously get kills. And so the only lane to really pressure is the Zeus in this situation. And they did a little good things once they got their Blink Dagger online. They went in and got some good pickoffs from HellRaisers. It's just I would just say they got outshined by the supports from Vega. Like, Vega supports played spot on this game and pretty much secured like early, mid, and late game for Vega here. Really well played from Solo and Soma.
Well, for now, that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. It's been fun. 23 minutes, and Vega put themselves even further up at the top. 8-2 is their current standing in the WePlay Season 3 EU East group stage. So, for myself and Ryu, have a good day. There's more WePlay coming up later on tonight, though. 9:15 PM CET. Dragon Drop's going to be covering Samurai Champloo up against Team Liquid. But there's also ESL Manila qualifiers and Dota Pit, where Cap, Modpax, and Toby will be casting for the rest of the evening. So make sure to check that out. The ESL underscore joinDOTA Red Twitch channel, as well as the Dota Pit Twitch channel, is where you can find those lads. A lovely cast. So goodbye. See you tomorrow. I've only got one game today. I'm kind of sad, but it was a fun one. The Global Strat from Vega. Thanks for watching, guys.